Hello everyone, welcome to the control system theory, the subject of electrical engineering. In this video, I am going to explain what is open loop system, what is the basic block diagram of open loop system, then how it will work, example of open loop system, then after what is the advantage and disadvantage of open loop system. Similarly, I am discussed here what is closed loop system, basic block diagram of closed loop system, then after example of closed loop system and advantage and disadvantage of closed loop system. First, we are discussing here what is open loop system. Open loop system, it is a control system where its control action only depends on input signal and does not depend on its output response as shown in figure. That is the basic definition of open loop system. Here, the basic block diagram of open loop system is here. It is contained controller plant. Here, input is given and output is here. That is the control signal. Here, the output does not depend on output response. It is only dependent on input. That is our open loop system. The examples of open loop system: traffic signal, washing machine, bread toaster, etc. I am taking simple example of open loop system, that is fan. Here, fan is open loop system. How it will open loop system, we are discussing here. If I am adjust regulator of fan at 2 number, then fan will rotate at the speed based on 2 number regulators. It will not depend on what is the temperature of the room. It will continue rotate. It will continue rotate at 2 number speed. If the temperature of room is cool or hot, it doesn't matter. That means here I am saying that its output does not depend on output response. The open loop system does not depend on its output response. Here I am set the number 2, then fan will continue rotate at speed of number 2. The temperature of room is cool or hot, it doesn't matter, it will continue rotate. If you want to change the speed of the fan, then we have to change the regulator step. If I am change regulator at number 3, then it will rotate fast compared to number 2. That means in open loop system, control action does not depend on its output response. It only depend on how much input is given to the control system. The simple and basic example of open loop system, that is fan. Now, we are discussing advantage and disadvantage of open loop system, which is very important. The advantage of open loop system is, it is very simple in design and easy to construct. That is economical, easy for maintenance, highly stable operation. These are the advantage of open loop control system. Then after, disadvantage: not accurate and reliable when input or system. Parameters are variable in nature. Recalibration of parameters are required time to time. If we are using control system like fan here for long time, then The maintenance of the system are required time to time. Otherwise, there will be some problem created. Okay, that is the disadvantage and advantage of open loop system. The block diagram of open loop system is here. The control action does not depend output of the system. It will only depend on input. You can understand open loop system by example of fan. That is very simple and basic example of open loop system. Okay. Now I am talking about closed loop system. It is a control system where its control action depend on both of its input signal and output response as shown in figure. Here in closed loop system, control action depend on both input and what is the output. That is our closed loop system, and basic block diagram of closed loop system is here. Here that is controller, that is plant, that is feedback element, and that is feedback signal. That is very important thing, that is the difference with open loop system. Here one signal is taken from this side and that is given to the at input side. That is feedback signal. And here we are giving input. While comparing this input signal and feedback signal, there will be error signal produced here. Just example, if our input is 20 and after response, if our feedback signal is 15, then the difference of this input and that our feedback signal, that is 5. That is the error signal and which is given to the controller. The example of closed loop system, that is automatic electric iron, missile launcher, speed control of DC motor and air conditioner, etc. Here I am taking one example for explaining closed loop system, that is AC. If we set the temperature of AC at 20 degrees Celsius, then it gives cool air to the room up to 20 degrees Celsius and its compressor is rotate continuously. But what happen if the temperature of the room become cool, then it's automatically shut off the compressor fan, because the temperature of room is very cool when we are set temperature 20 degrees Celsius. Then after, air conditioners shut off the compressor fan automatically because the temperature of room is very cool. Now what happened after some time when the temperature of the room arises, that means the present temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, and then when the room temperature increases, that is 22 degrees Celsius, then there is some difference. You can see here there is difference. First 20 degrees Celsius and then after it will increase 22 degrees Celsius, then that is error signal. You can say that is error signal. Then after controlling and processing, AC again switch on the compressor fan. Switch on the compressor fan and again it will rotate. When the temperature of the room falls down 20 degree Celsius, from 22 to 20 degrees Celsius, and Then after, again AC shuts off the compressor fan. You can see here all process of AC regulate automatically. That is our closed loop system, the best example of closed loop system. By comparing input and feedback signal, it generates error signal and it will give to controller. After processing, here you can get output, but on basis of error signal, some feedback signal is given and it will continuous work automatically when switch is on, when AC is on. The example of closed loop system are electric iron, missile launcher, speed control of DC motor, air conditioner, etc. Here I am taking example of AC. Now we are discussed advantage and disadvantage of closed loop system. First, I am discussing advantage of closed loop system. More accurate operation than that of open loop control system. Can operate efficiently when input or system parameters are variable in nature. Less non-linearity effect of this system on output response. High bandwidth of operation. There is facility of automation because it will work automatically on basis of error signal. Time to time recalibration of the parameters are not required. In open loop control system, here that is the recalibration of the parameters are required for time to time in open loop control system. This all are the advantage of open loop control system. Disadvantage of closed loop control system. Disadvantage of closed loop control system. That is complex design and difficult to construct than that of open loop control system, because that is fully automatically, so that the design is very complex and it's difficult to construct compared to open loop control system. Complicate for maintenance. In case of open loop system, the maintenance of open loop control systems are very easy. But in case of closed loop control system, it is very complicated. Less stable operation than that of open loop control system. Okay, that is the advantage and disadvantage of closed loop control system. Here, I am repeat again some important point of open loop system. Here you can see that there is no feedback element. It means the absence of feedback element. There is no feedback signal in open loop system. In case of closed loop system, you can see here that is feedback signal is present. And by comparing input signal and feedback signal, error signal generate, and on the basis of error signal, it will processed further. That is the basic difference between open loop system and closed loop system. Here I am taking example of fan for open loop system, and I am taking here air conditioner as an example of closed loop system, and discussed here advantage and disadvantage of open loop and closed loop system, which is very important point of control system theory. What is open loop system and what is the closed loop system. Now in next video I am explaining what is the difference, the basic difference between open loop system and closed loop system. That means comparison of open loop system and closed loop system I am discussed in next video. If you have any doubt and query, then I will solve it next video. Thank you very much.